He just dropped. Way. Dan hit the target.
Oh, welcome back. Jacqueline and I are out here just taking some photos for Jacqueline's Instagram, at probably Jacqueline, if you want to see the results of the shot. So we're flying, as we do on this channel. We're going over to my buddy's place. We're going to fly there. And if you remember in the last episode, we had a little weird issue with her Atom 80. It was kind of losing power on climb out, so hopefully we'll see if it returns, and if it does return, we'll fix it. Aside from that, my buddy Dan and Jeff are gonna be out flying. Me, on the other hand, I am planning on flying the trike mobile tonight and hopefully doing a tandem. I'm gonna go over and load up the trike mobile right now. All right, trike mobile's loaded. I don't know if you can tell, but I just switched lenses. You know those purchases that you're like, oh, I'll save it for a rainy day? I've been saving this purchase for many rainy days. This new lens I got, it's a 10-18 with optical stabilization. Please do me a massive favor and comment how wonderful it is in the comments. Just crispiest shot ever, so I feel better about my purchase. Thank you. Jacqueline, on a scale of 1 to 10, how awesome do you think my new lens is?
A 12.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So in the last video, we had some trouble with the Atom 80, like I was saying. I didn't get to experience, but Jacqueline, you said it kind of dropped power as you climbed out.
Yeah, it was weird because it did it when I ran it up to, like, I would start the motor, squeeze the throttle, and it would start going, but it would kind of drop power and then recover. Like it never happened, and just like clear itself.
So the armchair mechanics that I asked for their opinion in the last video have come to the conclusion that it must be carburetor icing. I want to agree with, but I also don't want to agree with, because that was apparently an issue in the last Atom 80 model, but this one was supposed to fix it. So I want to say it's bubbles from the primer, and I have a new primer on the way, but it's not here yet, so we're going to do more troubleshooting tonight. But hopefully just it's one of those problems that it's like a little, what do they call it? A gremlin. It's a gremlin in the system and it just randomly came up and then it's gonna run away and never come back again. Okay, so we've had a bit of a change of plans tonight. I was gonna do the tandem, but the winds are strong and that's not good for a forward launch on the tandem, and it's not good in terms of turbulence. So with it being Halloween, and with me standing in a pumpkin patch right now, we're gonna have a little contest. Dan versus Jeff versus myself. We're gonna drop pumpkins onto a target, which is right over in that field. I know the FAA is already getting dialed up right now by dude man eating chips in his mom's basement. But thing is, I need to find my color is yellow. One of the guys got white, one of the guys got orange. So I need some small yellow pumpkins. Squashes, gourds. I don't know what they are. They're aerial projectiles today.
Are in the air. We don't have a plan. We estimated that we will fly twice the tree height for all drops. You can see the target off in the distance to my right. We might actually want to do a north-south run. I'm going to prime my situation here by taking one gourd? Question mark? Putting it between my legs. Okay, looks like Dan's moving in for shot number one. He just dropped! Oh, nice shot! Oh, that's gonna be hard to beat. He was close. I would give that 5 feet away. Okay, we're gonna make a left-hand turn, fly at this altitude into the wind. Man, if we can get a bullseye, this would be legendary. Flying through the wake. 3, 2. Oh, I was way off. Okay, Dan totally crushed me on that one. I'm gonna have to drop way sooner. Let's prime another pumpkin, gourd, squash. I don't know my fruits and vegetables, obviously. Locked and loaded between the old thighs. Okay, it looks like Dan has got one ready to go. Oh, maybe Jeff is dropping right now. Jeff is definitely set up. He just dropped! Oh, I did the same thing. He hit exactly where I hit. And Dan? Oh, no freaking way! Dan hit the target! What the hell? Dan, how are you so good at this? Okay, I gotta hit the target this time. Way earlier. 3, 2, 1. Oh, good! Oh, that wasn't bad, but I was off to the side. How did Dan hit the target? What is he doing? He's lined up. Oh, he threw it down. I think that's how he got it. We're gonna get up close, see how Jeff does. And then I have one final shot at this. Lining it up, descending. And he dropped. Oh, not bad. He hit exactly where I hit both the first and second time so far. Jeff and I are on the same page. Dan is just on another level. Ah! I can't see. Okay, this is by far the smallest one so far. My final shot. Dang it! I was about 10 feet off. That was good though.
Jeff and I hit like the same spots and you just nailed it.
The second time, my other two were totally off. But
my
yeah.
last one was way off.
I screamed here. So loud, I was like, whoa! I was freaking out.
I couldn't get the damn thing out of the bag the first round.
Yo, oh, yeah. These were so easy on the side pockets. The bag was so hard.
It was hard to get out.
I pulled my last one out and the bag flopped over my whole face.
What a good Halloween so far, guys.
Right?
Yeah, not bad.
So as it turns out, the Atom 80 turned out to be a gremlin question mark. When I flew the motor, I had zero issues of it losing power like Jacqueline experienced. The good news is my primer arrived. And why do I want a new primer? Well, when we motor swapped the Atom, I was putting the new fuel tubing on this end of the primer. The hose clamp, I guess, wasn't clamped hard enough and the primer actually came apart. So I had zip tied it back together. So regardless, I want a new primer for just peace of mind. But maybe that's what was causing the problem, who knows. I also got a new bronze bushing kit. And yes, dude man who called me out in the comments, I'm not an idiot. It's actually called a bronze bushing by the manufacturer, in your face guy. And I also got this little part that I have found to be really hard to find. I didn't even know it existed. It's part of the throttle linkage. From the people at Glider Sports, so thanks for that. order fellas. Aside from that, the pumpkin drop was super awesome. It was super fun. Also, I'm hoping to do that tandem I was talking about in the near future when the weather actually cooperates and it's safe. It's just one of those things. You want to be doubly careful when it comes to tandems. So I hope you guys enjoyed today's episode. Make sure you drop a like if you did. Stay tuned for more episodes and check out the merch down in the description. Got a lot of hoodies on there. And I guess with that, I will see you guys in the next episode. Till then, peace.